Hi everyone, this is SET, the English Lit channel. Today we are going to discuss about the age of transition. First I have given the transitional poets first part. Because so many transitional poets are there, that's why I have divided into three. The first part I have given some of the writers. So you know very well, the age of transition began from 1720 to 2800. The first poet, James Thomson, was very popular in this period, and he wrote The Seasons, which was published in the year 1730. It has four parts, which describes a different season. The Seasons is a series of pastoral poems which celebrate the beauty and changing aspects of each season. And in this slide, I have given that first and last line of each and every part of this poem, The Seasons. First part spring, second winter, third autumn, and fourth one summer. And the next poem of James Thomson's is Liberty, which was published in the year 1735, and it has five parts. And this poem addresses the themes of freedom, political power, history of England, and advocating for liberty and just the rule. And this is a long philosophical and political poem which has 3,400 lines. Our next writer is Samuel Johnson, and who wrote London in 1738. And it was also published in the year 1738. It was set in the bustling city of London, and this poem describes the people of London. And this poem is all about us, satirical pieces of various aspects of London society, and also highlighting the moral destruction of the city. And the next writer is William Collins. William Collins wrote Persian Eclogues, which was published in the year 1742, and it is also written virginally for the entertainment of the ladies of Taurus. The eclogues draw inspiration from Persian literature and are set in a pastoral, idealized landscape. And it is all about the sepers and mythological figures. And it presented a series of poetic dialogues between shepherds and explores the theme of love, nature, and pastoral life with an oriental influence. And the next writer is William Sandstone, and his work is The School of Mysteries, which was published in 1742. The poem is set in a rural and pastoral landscape. It features various characters, including a mistress and her students. So the poem is all about a humorous and satires that pokes fun at the rural education of the country school mistress. The next writer is Robert Blair. He wrote the poem The Grave, which was published in the year 1743. The poem explores the theme of death and the afterlife. And it is all about a meditation on mortality and the human experience of death, providing a contemplative and melancholic perspective on life transience. And the next writer is Mark Akinsides, who wrote The Pleasures of Imagination, and which was published in the year 1744. This poem explores the world of imagination and aesthetics. The poem has written in three books, and this poem is a philosophical and reflective one which explores the creative power of the human imagination and its role in experiencing beauty and pleasure. Here we are going to see the another poem of Mark Akinsides, is an epistle to Curio, which was published in the year 1744, and it also addresses a specific recipient, Curio. The main character is the speaker addressing Curio, and it is a poetic letter that discusses political and social themes, including liberty, patriotism, and the role of the individual in society. So here I have given the first part of transitional poets. In my next video, I have to give the other transitional poets. please wait and see. Thank you.